Hello viewers, welcome to UN Digital class. In my previous lecture, I have discussed about knowledge-based agent and knowledge representation. Now, in today's lecture, I am going to discuss about one example of knowledge-based agent, that is the Ohm's world example. Now, let us start. Ohm's world is nothing but, it is a simple world which illustrates the worth of knowledge-based and the knowledge representation. Here, the Ohm's world is a cave which has 4x4 rooms connected with passways. So, there are total 16 rooms which are connected with each other. Which means, in our Ohm's world example, that is represented by a 4x4 matrix. And that matrix contains 16 number of locations or 16 number of rooms. Now, next. We have a knowledge-based agent who will go forward in this world, which means in Ohm's world, there is a knowledge-based agent and that agent can only move forward. Then next, the cave has a room with a beast which is called Ohms, who eats anyone who enters the room. That means in Ohm's world example, which contains 16 number of rooms, from that 16 number of rooms, in one room, there is a Ohms. That Ohms eats anyone who enter into that room, which room the Ohms present. Then next, the Ohms can be shoot by the agent, but the agent has a single arrow. Which means, here the agent has a single arrow through which it can shoot the Ohms. In the Ohm's world, there are some pits, rooms, and if agents fall in pits, then he will be stuck there forever. Which means, from these 16 rooms, some rooms, pits present. In which room pits present, if agent enters into that room, then that agent never come back from that room. The pits may eat that agent. Then next, the exciting thing with this cave is that in one room there is a possibility of finding a heap of gold. So, the agent goal is to find the gold and climb out the cave without falling into pits or eaten by Ohms. That means in our Ohms world example, from these 16 rooms, in one room there is a heap of gold. And the agent aim is to find out that goal and came out from that cave and it reached safely. If the agent can get that goal and come out from the cave safely, then the agent get rewards. If the agent eaten by Ohms, then the agent gives the penalty. That is the Ohms world environment or Ohms world problem. Next. This figure shows the Ohm's world problem. In this figure, now look at this location. First of all, here this Ohm's world problem is represented by a 4x4 matrix. That means here we have 4 rows and 4 columns. And these 4 row and 4 column creates a 16 room or 16 locations. And in the first location, that means in the 1, 1 location, here the agent is present. Then look at this location. In this location, the pit present. Now here, look at this location. Here the Ohms present. Now here the gold is present in this location. Then next, this location and this location, the pit presents. This is the environment or this is the Ohms world environment. Next is the pitch description of Ohms world. In pitch description, first thing is the performance measure. In performance measure, plus 1000 reward points if the agent comes out of the cave with the gold. That means, here in our Ohms world, if the agent find out the gold and came out safely from that cave, then the agent gets reward, that is plus 1000. Next, -1000 points penalty for being eaten by the worms or falling into the pit. That means if the agent fall into the worms room or eaten by the worms or it come to the pit's room, then the agent must give -1000 point penalty. Next, -1 for each action and -10 for using an arrow, which means here for every action taken by an agent, that is the -1 point. When the agent use arrow, then it gives us the -10 points. Next, the game ends if either agent dies or came out of the cave. That means in Worms World example or in Worms World, this game stops when the agent came out from the cave or when the agent dies. Now look at the next piece standard. Here the next one is the environment. That means this represents the environment for Worms World. Here first point is a 4-star 4 grid of rooms, which means in Worms World environment it is a 4x4 matrix or 4x4 rooms. Now next is the agent initially in room square, that is 1-1, facing towards the right. Next, location of worms and gold are chosen randomly except the first square 1-1, which means this environment says that the agent is initially present at the 1-1 location, and at that location there is no worms or no pit. That means in 1-1 location is safe for agent, and initially the agent is present in that location. Now next, each square of the cave can be a pit with probability 0.2 except the first square. That means it says that from the 16 rooms except the first room, the pit can be present any one of these rooms and the probability is 0.2. Next is actuators. That means here this actuator represents the Worms World agent to take the action. Here the actuators are, first one is the left turn, next is right turn, then next one is move forward, next grab, next release, next shoot. That means these are the different actions taken by the Worms World agent according to the current percept and the knowledge base. Next, sensors. Here the agent will perceive the stench if he is in the room adjacent to the worms, not diagonally, which means the agent perceives stench. Here stench is the input that perceives agent. When the agent perceives stench, if there is some worms present in its adjacent location or adjacent room, then the agent perceives stench. But that adjacent locations are not diagonally adjacent, that is the directly adjacent location. Next, the agent will perceive bridge if he is in the room directly adjacent to the pit. That means here the agent perceives bridge when the agent's adjacent locations contain pit, or if pit is present in its adjacent location, then the agent perceives bridge. Next, the agent will perceive the glitter in the room where the gold is present, which means when an agent enter into a room and at that room it perceives glitter if gold is present in that room. Next, the agent will perceive the bump if he walks into a wall, which means if the agent walks into a wall, then it perceives bump. When the worms is shot, it emits a horrible scream which can be perceived anywhere in the cave, which means when the agent shoots the worms, then the worms emits a scream and that is the perception of the agent. And that scream can be perceived at any room of the womb's world. Next, these percepts can be represented as 5-element list in which we will have different indicators for each sensor. Which means, in our womb's world example, it contains 5 sensors and each sensors always takes some input or perceives from the environment. Now look at the example, how the perceptions or input is represented in our womb's world example. Here, in example, suppose if agent perceives strange breeze but no glitter, no bump and no scream, then it can be represented as first percept is strange, then next breeze, then none, then none, then none. That means here the first percept always, that is the strange, and the second percept is breeze. If our agent finds no breeze or perceives no breeze, that means here this place we can write none. Now look at our example, no glitter, that means here we can write none. Then no bumps, that means here none. Then last one is no scream, that means here it is none. If our agent perceives some scream, then this location or this place we have to write the scream. That means here these 5 elements are nothing but these are the percept of our knowledge based agent or womb's world agent, which is perceived by using its 5 sensors. Next, the womb's world properties. In womb's world properties, first property is partially observable. Here, partially observable means the womb's world environment is partially observable, because in womb's world environment, the agent can only observe its adjacent locations. That means the directly adjacent locations. Here the agent cannot observe all the locations. For this reason, here the environment is partially observable. Then next, deterministic. Here in our womb's world environment, that is deterministic environment. Because here always the agent find out some result. When it perceives something from its current situation, then it performs some action. So that its environment is deterministic environment. Next, sequential. Here the womb's world environment is sequential, because here you have to maintain the sequence or order. Next one is the static. Here static means the womb's world environment is static, because in womb's world environment, the wombs and pits never changes their location. That is, we can say that the womb's world environment is static. Next, discrete. Here the womb's world environment is discrete. Next one is one agent. In womb's world environment, here always one agent perform the action, so that its environment is a single agent environment. Next, exploring the womb's world. Here, initially the agent is in the first room or on the square, that is one hour. And we already know that this room is safe for the agent. So to represent on the below diagram, that means in next slide I will show you the diagram, and that room is safe, we will add symbol OK. Now look at the next slide. Here in this slide, look at this figure, that is the figure 1. In figure 1, this A represents the agent. Here, before going to this figure, first of all I would like to discuss about these symbols. That means for A, it represents agent, and for P, which represents pit, and for W, which represents wombs, and B represent breeze, and S represent stains, and B represent visited, and G represent gold or glitter. Now come back to this figure. In this figure, now look at this location. This location is the one-on location, and in this location our agent is present. That means in this location there is no ohms or no pit, so that this location is safe and where our agent is present. For representing safe, here OK is written, which represent this location is safe. Now here when the agent present in this location, then the agent perceives nothing. Look at its perception. In its perception, every elements are none. That means the agent perceives nothing. No bridge, no stains, no bump, or no scream. Which means in its adjacent location, there is no ohms or no pit. Look at here adjacent location. Here this location, that is 2-1, and the location 1-2. These two locations are adjacent location of our agent. Now, here the agent perceives nothing. That means the pit or ohms are not present in this location. Also, the pits and ohms are not present in this location. So that here, these two locations are also safe for our agent. Now, look at the next figure. In this figure, now the agent decide to move from this location to this location, because when the agent present in this location, the agent perceives nothing, so that the agent clear that in its adjacent location there is no pit or no ohms. For this reason, the agent decided to move from this 1-1 location to 2-1 location. Now in this figure, the agent moves from 1-1 location to 2-1 location. Now look at here, at 2-1 location, the agent's perception. Here the agent perceives first one is none, second one is breeze, then last 3-1 is none. That means when the agent present in this location, the agent perceives breeze, which indicates that pit is present in its adjacent location. That means now look at the agent's adjacent location. Its adjacent locations are 3-1, 2-2 and 1-1. But here 1-1 location is already visited by our agent, and this location is safe for our agent, because in this location there is no pit or no ohms. Now the agent assumes that the pit may be present in this location or this location, because this location the agent perceives breeze. When the agent perceives breeze, that means it indicates that there is a pit in its adjacent location. So that the agent may assume that the pit may present in this location or in this location. So the agent now decided to return back to this location. Now look at this diagram or figure 3. In this location, now the agent return back from 2-1 location to 1-1 location, because in 2-1 location it perceives breeze, which indicates that there is a pit in its adjacent location. So the agent have no option to move to this location or this location, because the agent is not sure about that in which location the pit is present. So that the agent decided to return back from 2-1 location to 1-1 location. Now here the perception is nothing, because here the agent only return back from this location to this location, and in this location there is nothing which perceive the agent. Now look at the figure 4. In this figure, now the agent decided to move from this location to this location, because when the agent present in this location, the agent perceives nothing. That means the agent perceives no stains or no bees, which indicates that its adjacent locations are free from ohms and pit. So the agent already visited this location. Now the agent decided to visit this location. That means here in this figure, the agent moved from this 1-1 location to 1-2 location. When the agent moved to this location, now the agent perceives strains. Then the agent assumes that there is a ohms in its adjacent location. That means the wombs may present in this location or in this location. Because here these two locations are adjacent to this location. But now look at this location. This location also adjacent to this location. But here this location is safety because this location is already visited by our agent. Now look at these two locations. That means these two locations are adjacent to our agent. Now our agent assume that the wombs may present in this location or in this location. But when the agent visited this location, that is 2-1 location, then the agent perceives bees. And when the agent perceives bees, then the agent assumes that the pit may present this location or this location. Suppose pit present this location. If pit present this location, then now the agent must receive bees when it present in 1-2 location. But here the agent only perceives trains. That means the pit is not present in this location. Because if pit present in this location, then the agent must perceives bees when it present in 1-2 location. Which clear that the pit is present in 3-1 location. Now check for the wombs. Suppose wombs present in this location. If wombs present in this location, then when agent visited this location, then the agent must perceives strange. But when agent visit this location, the agent only perceives bees. That means the wombs not present in this location, which indicates that the wombs present in 1-3 location. From this, you clear that the wombs present this location and the pit present this location. Now the agent performs its next action because it clear that where the wombs present. The wombs present in 1-3 location. Now look at the next action. Here the agent clear that the wombs present 1-3 location. That means now the agent can only move from 2-2 location because this location is safe for the agent. Now in this diagram the agent moves from 1-2 location to 2-2 location. When the agent present in 2-2 location, now look at its perception. It perceives every element is none. That means this location is safe and there is no wombs or no pit in its adjacent location. Now from in this location the agent can move its adjacent location, that means to this location or to this location or to this location. But this location is already visited. That means the agent has two options. The agent can move this location or this location. Suppose the agent decided to move this location, that is the 2-3 location. When the agent moves this location, then the agent perceives trains, breeze and glitter. Which means now the agent find out the gold. Because when the agent perceives glitter, that indicates in that room the gold is present. Now in this location the agent find out the gold. That means now our agent stop here and find out the gold and came back from this cave. Here suppose the agent decided to move this location. If the agent moves this location, at this location the agent perceives bridge, which indicates that there is a pit in its adjacent location. That means the pit may present this location or this location. So that here the agent return back to this location, that means from 3-2 location to 2-2 location. After return back to this location, then the agent moved to this location. When the agent moved to 2-3 location, then the agent find out the gold. That is the aim of the agent. This is all about the Umswald problem. Here I have told you that the Umswald problem is the example of knowledge based agent. That means now one question may arise your mind that how the knowledge based is used in our Ohm's world example. Now, in our Ohm's world example, the knowledge base contains the information that is the conditions. And what are these conditions? These conditions are when the agent perceives strains which indicates that in its adjacent location there is a Ohm's. And when the agent perceives bridge that indicates that in its adjacent location there is a pit. And when the agent perceives bomb, that means it indicates that the agents walk through wall. And when the agent perceives gold, which indicates that in that location the gold is present. These are the prior knowledge which stored in the knowledge base of our knowledge based agent. When the knowledge based agent performs some action on its environment, then it takes the current percept and use the knowledge base. After that, it takes the action. Suppose the agent present in this location, and when the agent present in this location, it perceives bridge. After perceiving the bridge, this bridge is the current percept. When the agent perceives this bridge, then the agent uses its knowledge base. That means it assumes that there is a pit in its adjacent location, which means it uses its knowledge base. After that, it takes the action and decide to which location it moves. This is all about the knowledge based agent and the Ohm's world example. If you have any doubt regarding this Ohm's world, then you can write me in comment. I will reply you and discuss about your doubt. Thank you for watching.